in the Tour de France for the women, of course. She's won that Tour de France as well 2 years ago. And she's been, of course, the champion of Germany. That's almost an aside. She's done so much. She was seventh in Sydney in the Olympic Games road race, in the Olympic Games time trial, which really is one of her favourite events. So, well, this is the way to do it. I said they rode like professionals. They are now, because Carrigan, when you've got two teammates, you send one away and give the other one a chance to follow up in the slipstream of the chasers. And Sara Carrigan is doing it absolutely right by attacking. If she gets to the hill, this Queensland girl could be out of sight for the rest of the day. As we watch here now, Sara Carrigan swooping round past the pits for the last time. She is about 8 seconds, no more, ahead of Judith Arndt. Sara first hit the headlines back in 1998 when she was fourth in the World Junior Road Racing Championship. But she's been around so long, she should be on a pension, really. But in fact, she is only, and I can't believe this, she's only 23 years of age now. She's done so much with her career, and she's put herself in a real good position now. She made an incredibly good effort to catch those leaders. Yes, she could be a danger. She's latched on at the back. This is a huge effort now by Judith. And Judith Arndt is going to get across to Sara, but the trouble is that Arndt is going to contact Carrigan right at the moment they start the climb. And that will she have recovered in time to hang on to Sara on the climb? Because really, she's moved down towards the bottom of the cobble drop now, the area below the Acropolis, which has seen it all over the centuries that have gone by. But he's never seen an Australian take a medal in the Road Race Championship. Remember, there has only been one before. In 1992, Cathy Watt. There's a real chance there could be two now. There'll be two medals. It's a question of which colour. Carrigan deserves this. She got across to that leading group with a terrific inhuman effort on the previous climb. And then, after a quick word with Anoni Wood, she attacked and she's saying, I'm not coming through now. She said to Judith Arndt, a little shake of the head. She's put Arndt where she wants her. Now, this is like a repeat of yesterday finishing the men's race, because she's going to gamble here on the race catching up, and she's going to keep her watch looking over his shoulder just to see if they're closing in. Judith Arndt, I sometimes wonder why she does this. She doesn't look at anybody, she just rides, and it could cost her the silver gold medal. 900 metres to go now for the chase group. Arndt herself is looking over her shoulder now. Best place finish seventh, she grits her teeth. She can't have that much energy left now. This could be Sara Carrigan's greatest moment. It's a gold medal, surely, if she sits there. She mustn't panic. It is not an easy sprint to judge. It is slightly uphill after you make the turn. You don't get a second chance at hitting the finishing line. You've got to judge the jump to perfection. Why Arndt isn't using other tactics, at least to try and persuade, and she's trying to now. No, she's just looking over her shoulder. And Carrigan, as cool as you like here, the girl from the Gold Coast, she's not going to make any, and she's going to attack her, and she's going to attack her early. And look, Arndt has looked, where has she gone? It's all over. Judith Arndt is all over. Sara Carrigan at 250 metres is going to give Australia the gold medal. She's already smiling, and she has won that with some of the best tactics I've seen in women's racing. Carrigan gets the gold medal, the first since Cathy Watt in 92, the second in the history of women's racing. Arndt gets second place and seems delighted enough with that. And now it'll be the sprint for third. And can Anoni Wood get this? But Sara Carrigan, well, she can't believe it. She is well known here in the world of cycling. She was the World Cup leader for the first four races last year. And she won the World Cup event in Geelong, where she beat, from memory right, Katie McTeer, who's here for Australia in the pursuit still to come. Might even medal in that, but there's no doubt about the gold medalist today. Sara Carrigan deserves this gold medal. It was one for the textbook of how to ride a bike race. Cross to the leaders with pure strength, use a tactic to go clear, and then not overwork in case you're caught. Use the man who is, or in this case, the woman who is with you, Judith Arndt. And she made Arndt lead her out in the sprint. She never did anything wrong whatsoever. And she's now the Olympic champion. Judith Arndt, who's, by the way, born in September 1980, which makes her still 23 years of age. Incredibly young. And could even be one of the youngest winners of them. She might even be, come to think of it, the youngest.